What are some not fun facts? There's a plant in Australia called the Jimpy Jimpy tree that has hairs all over it that are small enough and are compared to hypodermic needles. And whenever a person touches the plant, these hairs stick into your skin and inject a toxin that causes a pain compared to the affected area being covered in acid and set on fire. And what makes it worse is that the pain lasts months to years. Edit. Changed spelling of some words. When it comes to heart disease, the very first symptom in roughly 1/3 of all cases is sudden death. Meaning you could be perfectly healthy and drop dead because you had heart disease and didn't know it. Check your family history, people. Some whales, when old, no longer have enough strength to swim for as long. So if they swim too deep, they might not have enough strength to swim back up to get air, so they end up drowning. Edit. Some people smarter than I have pointed out that they technically don't drown, but instead suffocate from the lack of air. This is apparently because whales have to manually breathe instead of it being done automatically. The reason why dogs love squeaky toys is because it sounds like tiny animals dying. If you get the roach infestation bad enough, they will eat your skin while you sleep. They will also crawl into your ear, which is a horrible, horrible experience. Someone commits suicide every 40 seconds. Statistically, at least one person who's on Reddit right now won't be alive tomorrow. Babies can die after consuming honey. The botulinum toxin, like the one in Botox, will paralyze their muscles, causing floppy baby syndrome. Edit. To clarify, the bacterial spores, basically a super resistant sleepy form of the microbe, are in the honey, not the actual toxin. After going into the human, they start the party and produce the toxin. The Spanish flu was one of the most lethal pandemics in history. Edited out the most. There are lots of elements that determine the deadliness of these various diseases and too much uncertainty and death tolls to say for sure which disease was the most lethal. People who caught it bled from their ears, experienced nausea and extreme fever, their skin turned shades of blue, and experienced extreme pain from the slightest touch. It caused internal hemorrhaging. 18-35 adults' immune systems, which would typically be considered the strongest, would react so strongly that their bodies would fill up with antibodies and fluid, literally drowning the infected with their own defense mechanism. This happened for a specific reason. See Peekman's comment. Edit. If you are looking for a good source, The Great Influenza by John M. Barry is a good one. You can die from Alzheimer's due to the brain forgetting how to swallow or breathe. Dolphins have been known to violently abuse female dolphins in groups. Sperm attracts ants because it contains fructose. I learned it the hard way this morning. Brain aneurysms can happen at any time in your life and you won't know until it's too late or if a doctor accidentally finds it. Horses can't throw up. If they need to throw up, they'll die. If you have two pregnant cows give birth at the same time and one cow's calf dies and the other mother cow dies, leaving her calf orphaned, you can skin the dead calf and drape the skin over the living calf. Then the living mother will believe the orphaned calf is hers by smell and pattern of the skin and feed the calf, keeping it alive. Edit. I just woke up for milking and to my surprise this post got a fair bit of attention, haha. I should note people nowadays would only do this if they had only the two cows and no neighbors to get milk off to hand raise the calf. Working on a dairy where we have many cows calving at the same time, we can just leave them with a group of mothers and someone will feed it. Usually we will milk the mother cow and hand feed the calves in a shelter as we're not a huge dairy. Second edit. A calf needs the first milk from a mother cow that's just calved. This milk is called colostrum. It contains all the antibodies that fight infections and bacteria and help boost the calf's immune system. You must get this into the calf within 6-12 hours of the calf's birth to help it survive and be healthy. If you only own the two cows and you have this exact scenario where one mother died and the other mother's calf dies and she refuses to take on the orphan calf and you have no neighbors with colostrum to bottle feed it, then this would be one way for you to keep this calf alive. Again, for the people who are saying other mothers take on the calves, this is true, but in the scenario I'm suggesting, the farmer only owns the two cows. When one dies, you're only left with the one cow, no other mothers to take on the calf. Heroin overdose is so prevalent and dangerous because of how fast tolerance bounces back. So let's say an addict gets arrested and is in jail for a few days, weeks, whatever. If they're a heavy user, even half the dose they last used could kill them. If you shine a flashlight smartphone on a newborn sea turtle for too long, which could be only minutes, it will start crawling around in circles, known as the ring of death. It means that the turtle's eyesight has been permanently damaged due to mistaking your lights for the moon that guides it to the sea. By doing this, you have doomed the sea turtle to death right after birth. It information was given to me by the Sea Turtle Preservation Society in the Atlantic, FL during a presentation. A cat's D is sharply barbed along its shaft. Some dogs have to get their esophageal glands squeezed by veterinarians, or their owners, if too much fluid gets stuck in them. Dogs usually help themselves with the issue though, by pooing or rubbing their butts on the floor. There is a whale called 52 Blue who sings at such a strange frequency he is unable to communicate with other whales. When running through a government test, the TSAR failed to find 95% of weapons that entered planes through the airport scanner system. Edit, while this blew up quickly. Pun intended. You are more likely to have met a future murderer than you are to have a lasting marriage. Japanese used to use prisoners to test how many bodies their sword was. They would stack prisoners on top of each other and however many the sword went through was how many bodies the sword was. Sharks eat their siblings before birth equals there can be only one. Cowgirl reverse cowgirl position is the most common reason for a man's deed to break. John Lennon emotionally abused his son Julian and beat his wives. That one day you will talk to someone for the last time. Criminals that are considered unattractive usually receive a 50% longer jail time than attractive criminals. The reason you shouldn't eat raw cookie dough isn't because of getting sick from eating raw eggs. You're pretty unlikely to get sick from eating a raw egg these days. The real reason is because you shouldn't eat raw flour, as it contains fecal matter from all the birds that pooped on the wheat while it was growing in the field, and there's no practical way to remove it during processing. For the average adult, there are about 10 pounds of organisms living in and on you that are exclusively not you. Sex slavery in America is worth 4 times more than the entire Burger King franchise. Edit, this statement was paraphrased from a decade-old article and is incorrect. I did some googling and the results are the wall of text at the bottom. Edit, initially this was just karma farming, but please take from this that sex trafficking and human trafficking or slavery as a whole is real and present problem across the globe. It's depressing and something people aren't normally aware of. My original statement and later interpretation of data unhelpful to serious discussion. Edit, please read this comment. It's the important takeaway here, and better written than I can communicate. Edit, for those people concerned or who want to help, start with your local resources on the issue. For people in the USA, Ontario, you can also go to volunteer and NG organizations. End Slavery Now has lots of resources for this. Really, the original statement was just a way of getting people's attention while giving them an idea of scope. The reality seems worse. My mediocre Google foo returns this result. According to the study in this article, for comprehensive list, Burger King is worth roughly $7.1 billion. McDonald's is valued at $130.4 billion. Conservative estimates of human sex trafficking put the value of that at roughly $100 billion. So the ratio I can find is actually more like globally. Sex trafficking is worth 14 times more than Burger King. I haven't found relevant data specific to the US. This is wrong. The data I was looking at wasn't even measuring the same thing. There's a type of fly that lays eggs in your skin. The injury only looks like a scratch until the eggs hatch. Edit. OMG, that's a lot of upvotes and I only got Reddit yesterday. Human flesh is not flammable. However, if it gets too hot, it boils and emits a gas that is flammable, which, if ignited, will melt through you like a candle through wax. Without modern air conditioning, heat deaths in North America would be in the tens of thousands annually. However, air conditioning is expected to become our biggest user of electricity, further exacerbating global warming and hence, the kind of heat that requires us to use air conditioners. It's a feedback loop of heat and consumption. An elephant can control its D and kill you with it. Horses can also freely move their D's, and often swing it around to masturbate. Edit. Okay, y'all grammar Nazis. Fixed its to its. It had been auto-corrected. Edit 2. Masturbate. Astronomer here. Despite science fiction telling you otherwise, currently we have no technology to stop an asteroid going to hit Earth. We are lucky that the dinosaur destroying sized ones are so rare at this point in the solar system's history that we have, probably, found most of the ones of concern. That said, we probably have asteroids that can destroy a city hits us once a century or two, which would obviously be devastating if it hits in the right place. And yeah, you can't find all of the ones of that size. The Russian meteorite a few years ago, for example, came from the direction of the sun. When it happens, all you can hope for is it hits a super remote area where there will be minimal damage, like the Tunguska event of 1908. Genetic diversity of lions and cheetahs is so poor that a single epidemic can kill them all in a few months. During earthquakes, skeletons rattle around in their coffins like maracas. Everyone has tiny mites living on their eyelashes. In ancient England, people used the tops of hollowed human skulls to drink and eat. At Harvard University, there is a book bound in human skin. There can be two skeletons in the female body at once, more if you consider multiple births. Crabs eat their babies and sloths can die from starvation with a full stomach. There are more bacteria on your body than there are people on Earth. You are roughly 30 times more likely to die in a motorcycle accident than car accident. This factors in the odds of being in an accident per mile, and the odds of the accident being a fatality. Forensic investigators love people with tattoos. It makes their job so much easier. For generations, the indigenous peoples of South America used blow darts laced with paralytic plant extract to hunt their prey. In the 1800s, English physicians who interacted with these indigenous South Americans recognized the possible uses of this paralytic agent, now known as tubercurine, as an anesthetic agent for surgeries. Physicians noticed that animals under the influence of tubercurine would become temporarily immobilized but would recover after a period of paralysis. According to these physicians, this discovery would revolutionize surgery as an anesthetic agent. So confident were they in their discovery that one of the physicians volunteered to undergo surgery under the influence of tubercurine to demonstrate its effectiveness. Unfortunately, he failed to realize that, although the drug was an effective paralyzing agent, it did not have any effect on the sensory receptors of the body, so he felt every cut of the surgery without being able to move or do anything about it. MCAT Biology. Edit. Thank you all so much for the likes and the added knowledge regarding the subject that I had no idea about. Horrifying but very interesting. There is such a thing as masturbating too much. Many reported cases of patients coming in with gangrene on their dongs and testes because they jerked it so much they made abrasions and skin tears on their manhoods. Their entire pride would turn dark purple and black. Some have even died of sepsis because of this. So TLDR to my hormonal friends, don't wank yourself to death. The sun occasionally lets out supermassive bursts of plasma energy called coronal mass ejections. These could knock out our satellites, power grid and internet for decades if it caught us off guard. One barely missed us in 2012, and another has about a 10% chance of happening in the next 10 years. There could be a wandering black hole coming right towards Earth right now, but we don't know about it. Years ago I saw an episode of A Monsters Inside Me where this guy was doing something outside and a fly flew into his eye. It only made contact for about a millisecond, but it was enough for it to lay eggs. After they hatched, they started eating his eye from the inside and he was starting to go blind until a doctor figured out what was wrong. Since then I get super paranoid whenever a fly goes anywhere near my face because of the not so fun fact that something like this can possibly happen to me. Gorillas will usually masturbate after battling with others. You may have heard on several occasions that coal fire plants release more radiation than a nuclear plant. And it's true. But the reason why is a bit disturbing. Nuclear power plants are closed systems, So whatever radiation that comes from it has to punch its way through several tons of steel and concrete. Coal fire plants are not closed systems. They dig stuff out of the ground and burn it, releasing all waste to the air. Coal goes through very minimal processing before it's burned compared to other sources of fuel. After it is dug, the coal is washed and mostly that gets rid of impurities such as sulfur and rocks of various minerals. However, there always remains a trace of impurities, and those impurities can be made up of naturally occurring radioactive elements, such as radium. The presence of radium in coal is usually in very small trace amounts. But when a coal fire plant burns 9,000 tons of coal every day, it adds up. Which means it releases more radiation than a nuclear power plant. And it's more dangerous because that radiation is coming from particles that are just out there, floating around in the air, which you can inhale BTW. Dolphins will use decapitated fish heads to masturbate. If you think I am joking, look it up. Each day, people drive drunk more than 300,000 times, but only about 2,800 are arrested. Edit. In the United States. Edit. There are more tigers kept inhumanely in the backyards of America than there are tigers left in the wild. 4,000 approx in wild. 6,000 approx in captivity. All national anthems are technically country music. Edit. Thanks for the silver hee-hee. You can shrink a head by sewing the eyes and mouth shut as well as closing any other openings and the filling the head with hot sand in order for it to shrink. Edit. So there is a bit more to the art of head shrinking. Like a lot more concerning the full process as well as all the cultural significance and such. I will be adding a link to the wiki page on this topic for whoever is interested for some reason. Here is the link more than. The Cavalier King Charles Spaniel has been inbred to the point where about 70% show signs of syringomyelia, a condition when its skull is too small for its brain. As its brain grows, the pressure on it causes extreme distress and pain, and they flop around looking like they have a seizure until the vet drills a hole in its skull to release the pressure. Oh, and bulldogs can only give birth via C-section cause their heads are too big for their mom's hips, and pugs are struggling to breathe their whole lives. Shameless plug to go to a shelter and not a small dog breeder. But definitely also non-fun facts. Most laugh tracks were created around the 1950s. You are hearing dead people laugh. Homeless people will be cut in half by 2025. Context. Everyone probably knows this one. But, the original voice actor for Ducky in the Land Before Time series was murdered by her father and then he torched the body. I believe her tombstone has Ducky on it as well as one of her lines from the movie. It's been a while since I read about it. If any apocalypse happens, anyone who takes medication daily is FKed. If you have a pneumothorax, collapsed lung, even once it's resolved you can never go scuba diving. Also, there's a 1 in 3 chance it will happen again within 12 months. But yeah, I can never, ever, go scuba diving. Dolphins have been reported to drown themselves and swim into ships' propellers to kill themselves after losing a dolphin close to them. This also happened when a dolphin trainer fell in love with the dolphin she was training and when she was arrested for having sex with said dolphin, the dolphin drowned itself. Edit. The dolphin fell in love with the trainer. Not the other way round. Also it wasn't sex. She just let the dolphin rub itself on her to relive its sexual urges. She wasn't arrested, she was taken away from the dolphin as it was during some experiments to talk to dolphins in the 60s. I linked to an article on it. The smell of vomit comes from butyric acid, as does the smell of Parmesan cheese. When given a sample of butyric acid to smell, test subjects were disgusted or pleased depending on whether they were told it was puke or palm. A dentist in China was once executed for comparing mangoes to a sweet potato. Someone in the world is either being kidnapped, raped, killed, prostituted, or starved. Edit. My most liked comment is about the trash can of society. The SAR missed 96% of contraband during an inspection in 2015. Male ducks gang abuse female ducks. After talking a photo of the new deceased Pelolin of Mayhem, guitarist Euronymous took bits of his skull to make necklaces and supposedly ate parts of Pel's brain. There's a deep sea fish, forgot the actual name, but the male fuses into the female till there is basically nothing left of him. All for the sake of reproduction. The human brain starts deteriorating after age 27. Oh. I got a good one. A baby's skull has two rows of teeth that are visible. Unless you truly want to be freaked out, don't Google images of a baby's skull. Seriously, don't. Edit, I warned you. Veterinarians that put down sick pets will say that the owner often chooses not to be in the room, leaving the pet frantically searching for its owner in the last minutes of his life. Giraffes are considered endangered. That it's much easier to find a statistical correlation than it is to prove a statistical causation. Oregano can legally have 1,250 bug bits in it every 10 grams. The marginal cost to, on average, save one life in very poor countries, is probably about $4,000-$5,000. Based on research by an organization called GiveWell that estimates that the most efficient charity can do so at about $3.40 per life. Just think about it. Edit, for those asking about how this number is calculated, I suggest looking up the organization's own page on the subject, but in essence it works like this. If a vaccine costs $1 to administer, but it only prevents an infection and subsequent death 0.1% of the time, then the cost life would be $1,000, because it would require 1,000 vaccines at $1 vaccine to save one life on average. The organization itself has a lot of stipulations on this number and only use it as one factor of many for recommending charities. The 90s were not 10 years ago. I will never be able to walk to Australia. The bird species of the protagonist parrot from Rio is now extinct. Ebba died of cancer in 1998. Armadillos can carry leprosy and can pass to humans just by being in proximity. They're burying Danny today, and I can't get to the funeral. He was a good friend and I'll miss him. Some of the nuclear waste we have produced will remain dangerous longer than any institution, religion, or written language has ever endured. To be clear, not longer than any particular written language has endured. Longer than written language of any kind has endured. Written language as a whole. Which, obviously, makes it even more dangerous. 1 in 6 men are victims of sexual abuse or violence. I am one of them. This week I was expelled from my university for speaking out about it. A university I had medically withdrawn from already from the PTSD I have developed directly from the attack, but also the subsequent harassment I suffered from by people protecting my attacker. I have had my future robbed from me for daring to come out about my violent victimization. There are almost no resources for men like me. Almost no shelters. Few programs. And few are talking about this. Almost every human on earth is host to some type of parasite, even in first world countries. Cell phones are 11 times dirtier than a public toilet seat.